Hi everyone, welcome to my second break it down video. Today I'm going to show you how to reproduce this shabby chic door. Before we start building, make sure you have every furniture written on the lists that follow. When you do, we can get started. First of all, you need to figure out where you want to place your door. As you can see on the video, I use the wall tie to pinpoint the location where I want my door to be built. Once you figured it out, you will need to float one or two glade cupboards. The option with two cupboards is to show the thin lines on the sides of the furniture on the final custom door. One important thing, if you want the cute wooden detail on the bottom of the door, you will need to float the glade cupboard high enough for it to appear because it is a part of the furniture. It can be a slow process, but since this furniture is easy to float, it shouldn't be too much of a pain, so don't get discouraged and take your time. Now, for the other wooden detail with the cute flowers, you will need yet another glade cupboard. I promise this is the last one. Turn it in a way so you can see its sides and place it in front of the glade cupboards that you previously floated. You can either stick it really close to the door or a bit away to add some depth. It's your choice. Then you float at a desirable 8 and rotate to make it stay. This next step is pretty easy. Take two wood slat partitions and place them around the floated furniture to create the skeleton of the door. If you floated two glade cupboards previously, you can place the wood slat next to the thin wooden line detail. But, well, there are multiple ways to arrange this door, so just go with whatever you prefer. Alright, so we are now at the last step of this break it down. You will need pretty much any hanging furniture to close off the wooden line you created to surround the door. However, I recommend you to use either the hanging bookshelf, cupboard or sideboard since their texture is pretty constant compared to others. So, just float your hanging furniture at the desirable 8 and rotate. I highly recommend you to hide the rectangular partition behind this custom door to prevent the camera from seeing through the furniture you used to build it. We don't want to see jars and dishes, no sir. Also, you don't have to hide the whole glade cupboard since, as you saw, there is some cute little detail higher on the furniture. So, let your imagination go wild and try things out. It can end up in a pretty cute door. Just don't forget to place the handle, it goes without saying, but it does complete the door design very well. So this is the end of this break it down video. If there is a custom furniture you want me to break down and make a video of it, just let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching et à la prochaine!